Hey there, Glenn. My name is Dr. Rao. I'm going to be your anesthesiologist.
Okay.
Okay, I know you've got a bit of a cough there, and we're going to take care of you. Can you tell me, do you have any medical problems at all?
I have high blood pressure and diabetes.
Okay. Shall we do our safety pod?
Okay. If we're ready to do our brief, so if we can start by introducing ourselves. I'm Vicky LeBlanc, I'm general surgeon.
I'm Michelle Chiu, it's her good nurse.
Purnima, Rao, anesthesiologist.
Okay, so we're going to confirm that this is Glenn Posner. Hi, Glenn. We're going to take good care of you today. So Glenn is here for exploratory laparotomy with a midline incision.
Right. Thank you. I've done my safety check. His score is 3E. We'll give 2 grams of cefazolin based on his weight. He has no allergies. We will use special airway measures, which we'll discuss shortly. We'll put an upper body bear hugger on him, and if you could use up to 40 cc's of 0.25% bupivacaine at the end of the case.
Okay, so I think the next thing we're going to do here is...
Take
the
nice deep breaths, okay?
Yeah. Two of us are going to go through our airway checklist to make sure everything's ready. Can you just take us to FedEx? Michelle, can you just make sure the patient's fully monitored?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, so we're going to optimize patient positioning, which has been done. We're going to make sure that he's deoxygenated 5 minutes to the 100% non-breathing amount. And so that is on him right now, and he is receiving oxygen, so our pre-oxygenation has started. He is hemodynamically stable and well resuscitated. We're going to minimize any aerosol generating technique, and we're going to make sure that a minimal number of people are here in the room for this. We're going to avoid manual ventilation, and if required, we'll use a two-hand technique. And our backup, if that is not effective, is to use a super glove that way. We're going to use a rapid sequence induction. I have ketamine and rock pneumonium, and we do also have appropriate vapor cuffs available for this patient. We're going to use a glioscope as a primary technique. We're going to have to get a blood pressure shot in there. Just to get the fiber.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
I'm just going to call our attendant to do that. He's sterile.
Okay, thank you very much.
Great.
We have dilated endotracheal tube right here. And I have a dilated endotracheal tube on top. And we're going to make sure that we... Okay, good. We're starting to go there. After I intubate the patient, we're going to make sure that the inflate the cuff before we start
inflate the cuff before you start.
That's correct. I've already checked the machine to make sure that the connections are tight to minimize the risk of disconnect. And once Dr. Glenn's up, we'll ask if she needs to manage. So the step that I'm going to ask you to do is I'm going to manage the patient's airway with the drugs, but I'm going to make sure that the machine and ventilator is as clean as possible. So I'll ask you to turn on the ventilator and also manage the end site. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright. Okay, so Glenn's been receiving oxygen by a non-rebreather for 5 minutes now. Glenn, very shortly, we're going to get you off to sleep. I just want you to keep taking some slow, deep breaths in and out.
Good.
So, Steph, I'm going to do a charting. You can see this was recorded, and I'm giving 1.5 milligrams per kilogram. You're telling me?
There's big breaths there, Glenn.
Nice, slow breaths as you fall asleep. We'll take very good care of you. And we'll see you when you wake up. No, thank you. Ketamine's going in. Should start to drift off the sleep slowly. Okay. The deep sleep, we're going to give 1.5 milligrams per kilogram of rock pneumonia. Okay. So we're going to wait for 45 seconds for the rock pneumonia to have work, and then we'll proceed to intubate. Okay, so Steph, can you please just turn on the twitch monitor, please?
Sure. Okay. Yeah, I see it there.
There's no twitches. Okay. I'm going to proceed here. I'm going to take this off. And I want to make sure that this is as far away from us as possible.
the stylet out, please? And I will take the stylet out. I'll take the stylet from you. Great. And we'll have it cuff up. Cuff up.
Yeah. All the way up.
All the way up.
Got the tube.
Thank you. So we are connected and the cuff is up. So can you please turn on the ventilator? Okay. And we're going to confirm end-tidal CO2. We're going to confirm intubation using end-tidal CO2 instead of auscultating. Okay, and I see end-tidal CO2. So can you see where I am with this table? So Michelle, shall we still have the tube? Can I have some cake, please? I just want to let everybody in the room know that I'm going to have to change the filter in my circuit, which means that the airway is going to be open for a period of time. So, Dr. LeBlanc, if this is a good time, can I ask you to just stop operating and maybe move away from the patient?
Yeah.
And I'll ask our nurses to do the same. And Michelle, I think that we could have as few people close to the airway as possible. So I think that this is something I can do on my own. So just ask you to take a couple steps back as well.
Okay.
And if I need some help, then I will ask for it. Can you please pass me a new filter, which I see right there, and also a plan for the other fifth wheel tube? Okay, thank you. So can we make sure you have the patients on 100% oxygen for some time? Okay, thank you. And now what I'm going to ask you to do is switch the patient onto the bed and just pause our gas flow. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, so I'm going to clamp the endotracheal tube. I'm going to disconnect our circuit here and place a new filter on. Okay, so my new filter is on. I'm going to take this away. I'm going to unclamp my endotracheal tube. And if we can turn the ventilator back on, please. Good. And can I confirm that we have end-tidal CO2? Yes. Okay, so I think we can resume operating now. Thank you, everybody. So, once again, our emergence and extubation is going to be an aerosolizing procedure. So I think we'll minimize the number of people in the room. See that our surgeons and left are standing outside in case we need help. And we'll keep the three of us in the room as well. Can we just go through again our guidelines to see what the suggestions are for transfers and extubation? So we want to limit coughing. We consider strain, effective accommodating our alveoli pain. And we're going to make sure that as soon as the patient has been extubated, that we place a non-completed face mask immediately post-extubation and put a face mask over top of that again. So I'm going to use for the patient who's on a ready central infusion. We have a face mask. We're going to turn off our volatile anesthetic, please. Okay. And we're going to do this with a no-touch wake-up. Actually, before you do that, can you please turn it back on again? We want to use the patient again. Thank you. So I'm going to make sure the patient has an adequate depth of anesthesia and I'm actually going to suction their airway with 10 feet. And again, I recognize some aerosolizing procedures. You guys can just step back as much as possible.
I'm going to turn on the suction there.
Yeah. Just to the... Again, you can turn off our anesthetic. We do have a really sensitive infusion that we're running. And we're going to wait for the patient to start spontaneously ventilating. So can you put the patient on pressure support ventilation, please? So Michelle, when this patient is awake, we're going to extubate.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as this comes off, we're going to cover the face with this, followed by that mask.
Okay.
Okay.
He's starting to breathe and he's opening his eyes a bit.
Glenn, can you open your eyes?
Yes.
Hey, great. Okay, your surgery's all done. I want you to take a couple big breaths in and out. Okay, so we're seeing good tidal volumes there. Glenn, can I get you to squeeze my fingers? Okay, great.
So, touches as well.
Okay, so looks like he is spontaneously ventilating away from all the command. And then we're going to extubate him with the filter in place. Okay, so we're going to do this on the time. Great, Glenn, big breaths in and out.
Do you want to do this while I?
Yes, thank you. Yeah. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. All right, big breaths in and out.